Professor D.M. Jain, Vice Chancellor Abid Salami, Professor G. Raviram, Director, Srimati Manjushri Kaitan, Member of the Board of Governors, Professor M.M.S. Anand, Registrar, Members of the Board of Governors, Members of the Senate, Faculty and Staff Members, proud parents, and dear graduating students. It is indeed a pleasure for me to be with you on this convocation day. I've heard much about this university, but this is the first opportunity I had to actually visit and participate in a function. For any university, the convocation ceremony is one of the most important events in its calendar of activities. It is the day when we come together to recognize publicly the efforts and achievements, not only of a graduating class of students who have excelled academically, but also of the institution which is their alma mater. I congratulate the successful graduates, postgraduates, and award winners, as well as their proud parents, who must have put in a great deal of effort and sacrifice to get their children educated here. I hope that you will use the knowledge and skills you have acquired here to serve the people of our great country and pave the way for a progressive new India. Born as a small pathshala in Pilani in 1901, this institute has evolved over the years into the Birla Institute of Technology and Science, becoming a deemed university in 1964. I today pay my tribute to the vision of the founder, the great P.D. Birla, and all those who went in to create what this institution is today. I have always said the great Birla family has had establishments all over the country, but not in Jhunjhunu and Pilani. But instead, I think they have invested in creating men and women as human resource to pioneer the industrial revolution in the country. This institute has been amongst the pioneers in establishing systems and curricula which are now standard best practices worldwide, adopting the semester system and a modular structure of courses. You were among the first to introduce the online admission test, over which the Minister for HRD and the IITs are today involved in a great big controversy and debate. That the girls have lost out in the online admission test. Their numbers have come down from 45% to 25% because their 12th standard marks set them far above the boys. But when it came to the online test for admission, I think most families invest more in training and coaching the boys and the girls, and so they do better when it comes to the admission test. But anyway, I'm sure the girls will catch up before long. The university today has established three new campuses in Dubai, Goa, and Hyderabad. the Vice Chancellor, dedicated faculty, and committed staff have worked ceaselessly to make this university a center of learning and deserve appreciation for it. I congratulate them on their many achievements. You have now ventured onto an ambitious plan to modernize the campus, set up new laboratories, increase faculty strength, and expand student intake. I wish you success in your Vision 2020 Parivartan Strategic Plan. Science and technology have greatly influenced the course of human civilization and continue to hold the key to future economic growth and social development. It is important that universities create an environment sympathetic and supportive of innovation aimed at bettering people's lives. I'm reminded here of a famous quote which says, "Education begins when qualification ends." The changing times, global competition, and the positioning of India as a rising power is a challenge to the academic fraternity. The knowledge era of today must produce thinkers who have the capacity to envision the unvisioned, to articulate the unarticulated. Benchmarks and records of the past are meant to be broken. The hitherto hidden realms of science and technology to be explored, and the minds of our young open to the limitless opportunities that this age of knowledge offers. The essence of technical learning lies in questioning the assumptions. Asking why not leads to creativity and lateral thinking. The students must go beyond the normal syllabus framework and structure, and institutional processes must be adapted by young minds to create a blueprint of action for enhancing the quality of human life. We all speak of GDP growth, production, exports, SEZs, and MNCs. They are today branded as growth stimulators. But growth and development for whom and at whose cost? Where and to whom are these benefits going? We see the gap growing between the rich and the poor, the urban and the rural, the haves and the have-nots. With all our plans for development, we are today ranked at 138th position in the UN Human Development Report. Wow! The areas of engineering, technology, medicine, and basic sciences, coupled with management expertise, have to move hand in hand to achieve the goals of development. Research must also focus on the issues facing rural India and the poorest of the poor. Can the gaps be bridged? In keeping with the priorities set by your former Chancellor and my colleague in Parliament at one time and a friend, the late Dr. K.K. Bidla, to quote him, "To prepare young men and women to act as leaders for the promotion of economic and industrial development of the country and to play a creative role in service to humanity," unquote. This technical university must build its own capacity to assist the core infrastructure sector in meeting developmental challenges with a complete new mindset based on application of appropriate technologies aimed at inclusive growth. In view of this, it becomes imperative for a university like this to emerge as a nodal hub and center for transfer of academic excellence to productive processes. Your institute continues to be a front runner in designing and offering innovative curricula. Your practice school program, where you spend time in an industry as a part of your curriculum, under the guidance of your professors and industry experts, is worthy of praise and emulation. The dual degree program, where science students work for an engineering degree concurrently, is another unique offering. Your work integrated learning programs offer an opportunity to working professionals to upgrade their knowledge. You have also management, pharmacy, and general studies courses which enable you to go into various fields. A whole new set of initiatives will have to be taken to not only upgrade the skills of the taught, but also of the teachers. Furtherance of academic qualifications gives professional competence, and everyone in the teaching fraternity must strive for that. Coupled with this, of course, the conditions of service and the academic freedom of the teaching fraternity must receive special attention. Universities can help the nation by being cradles for human resource development, economic vitality, scientific and technical capabilities, and also by providing an impetus for social change and global competitiveness through innovation and research. And I was glad to note from the report that BITS is going to lay greater emphasis on research in the years to come. Universities must contribute to the cultural and social life of the community as well through outreach programs that enable students to interact with local communities and understand their concerns. They must become messengers of change. They should emerge as trained individuals who seek not only their own good, but are also motivated to serve those in need. I'm happy to note that the students of this campus have shown a commitment to social causes and are involved in community services as members of the NSS and Nirman. Look around you and have the courage to serve as path breakers, as lights in the gloom that surrounds us. I am especially pleased to note that you have a Center for Women's Studies, an initiative I have launched as Minister for Women in the Rajiv Gandhi government, which is trying to address specific issues of concern to women and working to improve their status by organizing training and skill-building programs. We must find ways to strengthen the hands of our women through policies and programs that enhance their abilities while reducing the drudgery of their lives. They must be empowered through appropriate technological inputs and enterprise development training that meet specific gender needs. Higher education in India faces many challenges today. There is a great demand for quality education. The government is trying its best to bridge the demand-supply gap. Government agencies, regulatory bodies, and private universities should work together to evolve a consensus on creating and sustaining centers of excellence. Education for All is our slogan. RTE is in place. A quality education, committed teachers, and employable youth are still a far cry. How many of our youth can hope to enter the portals of a university like this? How long must they wait, and why? I once again congratulate those receiving their degrees today. You go out as ambassadors of this great university. And as such, you have a great role to play. You have to rise above self for the well-being of others. You have to challenge yourself for surpassing your performance in the classroom through your contribution in its application outside. It is not just the aim of campus recruitment, in which I know BITS is ranked among the top IITs in the country, but you have to look beyond. This university has sought to imbibe in you the highest standards of individual and professional excellence. You are the prized leaders of tomorrow. You must make the nation proud of you. Thank you and Jai Hind.